grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
As we remain standing.
O God, the Maker and Redeemer of all, grant us with your servant passing and all the faithful departed the sure benefits of your Son's saving passion and glorious resurrection, that in the last day, when you gather up all things in Christ, we may with them enjoy the fullness of your promises. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the reading of the word, and I will invite Stella.
A reading from the Ecclesiastes. For everything there is a season, and time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to break, down, and a time to build up. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to throw away stones, and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to throw away. A time to tear, and a time to sow. A time to keep silence, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time for war, and a time for peace. Listen for the leading of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.
We're going to sing Psalm 23. It's in the hymn book. It's number 519, The Lord's My Shepherd.
Oh,
Jesus said to the disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, and the truth, and the life." The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Woman. I recall being around 9 years old, watching with eyes wide open as she would get dressed to go on a date. It seemed like only yesterday. No one I know could put eyeliner on as accurately, neatly, and quickly as she did, or create her own updo that was so stunning using toilet paper rolls. All things because they cost nothing. Her fingernails were always long and polished, and many times she sported the shortest shorts for that time period. You know what? She was sincerely a knockout. Well, actually, I do know someone who can do the same thing in a moving car as a passenger or a driver, and that would be her beautiful daughter, my niece Heather, who is in Trinidad as we celebrate Glenda right now, attending her mother's funeral. Glenda was a fabulous cook and housekeeper, and you better ensure that everything was in its right place. She also really loved gardening. But what happened to this lovely, gifted woman that I remember? For those of you here today who knew her, there are some of my memories that might have influenced her decisions, which resulted in many consequences that were painful, and some that were absolutely wonderful. Glenda was going to become a teacher. And then she lost someone that she cared about very deeply. And as I recall, he drowned, and his body was never recovered. I cannot imagine how painful that experience would have been for her. And then she met and married Heather's father. Unfortunately, that relationship did not work out, so she continued to look for that special someone. So after many traumatic liaisons, Glenda actually met the one 12 years ago. His name is Michael. And I ask that we all lift Michael up in prayers as he's recovering from a stroke that he suffered several months ago. Glenda and Michael adored and loved each other. They created a beautiful home for themselves, located in the northern hills in a small little village called Brasso Secco. And that is where Glenda's ashes are going to be scattered. I spoke to Glenda on Christmas Day, and she was kind of excited and happy and said, "Oh my gosh, my little sister." I called her again on January the 4th, but she didn't answer the phone, which is so unlike her. I would find out 2 days later that she had died and was not discovered until January the 6th by her stepdaughter, Angela. Her death was a result of a massive heart attack. In my heart and in my mind, I believe from a broken heart. Being a devoted Roman Catholic, she was very involved with her parish, and I know that she would be missed by her church family. Glenda's trials and tribulations did not shift her faith, nor her ability to forgive, and most importantly, to love. She loved even those who may have hurt her. And to me, that was a remarkable quality. So here's a quote that I came across on forgiveness. "Often there are many wrongs that we should all forgive, even wrongs that make life so very hard to live. But if we all do forgive and even learn to forget, life's road would be smoother, for we would have deterred regret." I am sorry that Glenda did not have Michael beside her at the time of her death. I believe that her last words could have been, "Heavenly Father," and then Michael. Now, as she's wrapped and cradled in the warmth of our Heavenly Father's arms, we, all of us, also have the promise of being with each other again in a heavenly life, free from pain, suffering, and strife, and surrounded by all our loved ones. Rest in peace, sister of mine. You have always been in my heart and prayers, and you always will be.
I speak to you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
this sermon is not too raw. 2 weeks ago, my wife died, so I know more about grieving than I did 2 weeks ago. For everything, there is a season, a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance. Eddie tells me Patsy loved to dance. She is dancing now. She is dancing with the one who loves her and knew her before she was yet born. Life is not just either or. Life is also both and. Yes, Patsy has died. And yes, Patsy has been born into a new world where death is no more, either pain or crying, when the first things have passed away. We stand on this side of the river of life and we wave goodbye. We grieve the loss of Patsy, the ones we love. Our hearts are heavy, and we sometimes forget that on the other shore of the river of life, loved ones are waiting to welcome their loved one into the celebration of that source of love from which we all come. For us on this side, on planet Earth, death seems to catch us a bit flat-footed. We often think, if I had known they were going to die this year, or this week, or this day, then I would have. I would have done this, or I would have said that. But death is so final. Or is it? After Jesus' death, the disciples entered into their deepest and fullest experience of him. And it was only after Jesus' death that they truly embraced his legacy. Patsy has left you a legacy of love and forgiveness. What better legacy could a big sister give her little sister? Her family, and her friends. It's a bridge strong enough to span two shores. Well, it's good that you're here to support Eddie and family. And as you're here, we recognize that there is probably a diversity of people, people from the many tribes of Christianity. Some of you may be Jewish or Buddhist or Hindu, all are welcome here. Some of you may have a more humanist view of life. So there's space for everyone here. We've really come to love and honor and celebrate Patsy or Glenda and to support Eddie. For those of you that will, you're invited to stand, and if it is your faith, to confess the faith of our baptism. As we say together the Apostles' Creed, on in the Green Book, on page 570. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in
crucified, died, and was buried.
He descended
into the dead.
Amen.
Let us pray that God will grant comfort and strength to all who mourn. God of grace and glory, we thank you for Patsy, who was so near and dear to us, and who has now been taken from us. We thank you for the love she offered and received while she was with us on earth.
We thank you for the friendship she gave and the passion she brought into our lives.
We pray that nothing good in Patsy's life will be lost, but will be of benefit to the world, and that all that was important to her will be respected by those who follow.
May everything in which she was great continue to mean much to us.
We pray that we who were close to Patsy may be even closer to each other now as she could die. We pray that she may go on living in her family and her friends.
May she live in our hearts and minds, in our courage and our consciousness.
We pray for ourselves, who are severely tested by Patsy's death, that we do not try to minimize this loss or seek refuge from it in words alone, and also that we do not brood over it, so that it overwhelms us and isolates us from others.
May God grant us courage and confidence in the new life of Christ. We ask this in the name of the risen Lord. Amen.
The gift of Christ is the gift of peace. The Lord be always. And also, feel free to offer your neighbor peace.
Thank you.
Obviously, we've been using story and metaphor. Of course, each of our lives are a story. So when we talk about a further shore or a river, or when we talk about dancing or seasons of time and compare that to our lives, these are all metaphors. The great metaphor for the mystery after death, of course, according to the Bible, it's a wedding party. And it's a great party, and people are eating together and rejoicing. And so we have that party now for those of us that follow the Christian faith. So if you're a Baptist, a Pentecostal, Roman Catholic, Anglican, you're all welcome to the party. In fact, everyone's welcome to the party, but we realize some of you may be following other faiths, which from our perspective all leads to the same party. But everyone's welcome to find their own comfort zone. We're going to celebrate Eucharist. That gives us great comfort as we think of that banquet that we all share in the end. And if you would like to be part of that banquet and you've never been in an Anglican church, you want the bread, the body of Christ, put your hands up to receive the bread. If you want to share in the chalice, the cup of wine, you got it to your lips. If you want none, but you'd like to be blessed, well, of course God loves you. That's why we're here. We can come to the altar rail and if your hands are folded, we know you'd like the blessing. And if you're just sitting comfortably in your pew, sending love, heavy in family's way, that's a good thing too. Find your own comfort in this part of the service. Your gift is your presence here. We begin on page 580. For the remembrance of me. where Jesus took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to his commandment,
we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory.
And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, Lord, Paul, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood in the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable in him, may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new. And bring us to that city of life, where you dwell with all your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By whom and with whom and in whom in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
As our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father in heaven, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
This is the bread which has come down from heaven.
Those who eat this bread will live forever.
The gifts of God for the people.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Father's love, you have fed us at the table of your kingdom. Teach us to trust without fear in your eternal goodness and mercy. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, your Lord. Amen. Share some memories and some love. The Lord be with you.
And also be with you.
And may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, our great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, equip you with everything good that you may do his will, working in you that which is well pleasing in his sight. Through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us go in peace.